Guys, today I am here to clearly explain with the examples that what are the axioms of probability. This lecture will clear you all concepts about the probability, and probability will make very easy. You can trust me. So don't miss this video, and we must watch this video from starting to end. And without wasting any time, let's start the lecture. So here, first of all, I'm going to discuss the first axioms of probability. This lecture is not available in any part. This will clear you all concepts. So let's suppose that we have A. You can say that A is an even. 1, 2, 3. Let's suppose that it is the even. And must remember that probability of A, you can say that probability of an even is always lies between 0 and 1. What means that? What means that probability of A lies between 0 and 1? How? How to prove it? I will discuss the examples also. So that means there, probability of A is always equal to 1. That's clear. Number one point. Number two point, that means here, probability of A is always less than 1. Number two point here. And must remember that probability of A can never be greater than 1. Must remember, probability of A can never be greater than 1. It's proved that probability of A is always equal to 1, and probability of A is always less than 1. But can't be greater than 1. Must remember. This is the first point. And just discuss the example. So let's discuss the example here. That will clear you all concepts about probability. And it may easy. So let's suppose that probability of A. S is the, you can say that 4, 1 dice. 4, 1 dice. You can say that S, which is, you can say that total sample space. S is the total sample space. Total sample space, which is here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Because note that dice has a 6 sides. Now I'm going to calculate that how probability of A is equal to 1, how probability of less than 1. I'm going to prove that with example. Probability of A, first of all, I'm going to calculate the probability of A. What is the probability of A? What is the probability of an even? It's always equal to number in A, this shows that number in an even A divided by number in total sample space. That's clear? So you can hear it. A is given here 1, 2, 3. Count that the values are 3 values. Number in sample space 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We're going to calculate. 3 was the 3, 2 the 6, 1 by 2, which is equal to 0.5, which is less than 1. So I proved that probability of A is equal to 1, or you can say that less than 1, but can't be greater than 1. I hope that you have cleared the first axiom of probability. I hope that you have, this is very easy. Now I'm going to move the second axiom. This will also clear your concepts. This is probability of S is always equal to 1. How? What is S? Here, S is a short event. S is a short event, not a sample space. This is the S is a sample space, but here, S is a short event. You can say that S is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is just like the sample space, but here in this axiom, S is showing here any event, not a sample space. That's clear? So here, probability of S, you can easily calculate. Probability of S is equal to number in an short event, which is S, and divided by number in total sample space. This is the total sample space. This is total sample space. Now I'm going to calculate here. number in sample space. So here number in sample space are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So here I put here 6 over and it's total sample space. What is the total sample space? The total sample space is here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Put here 6 maximum answer will be easy. So here I prove that probability of S is always equal to 1. This is the proof. I hope that we have cleared the also second axiom of probability. Next, now I'm going to move the last axiom of probability. This is also clear to all concepts. So here, third, what is the third axiom? If A and B, if A and B are mutually exclusive events, mutually exclusive events, then must remember that probability of A union B is always equal to probability of A plus probability of B. Must remember. Now first step is here. What are the mutually exclusive events? This is the main point. What are the mutually exclusive events? Let's take an example. And also I am going to prove that probability of A union B is equal to probability of A plus probability of B. I am going to prove also with example. Now let's discuss the example. So here, what are the first point is here? How A and B, what is mutually exclusive? Let's suppose that A is equal to 2, 4, 6. And you can say that B is equal to 1, 3, 5. This is the even number, this is the odd number. What means that mutually exclusive means? It means they have not any common points. And must remember that what are the mutually exclusive events? You can say that if A and B are no common points, that's called as mutually exclusive. Let's discuss here. Here is 2 is not given. Here is 4 is not given. And next is here is 1, but here 1 is not given. Here 3 is not given. Let's suppose that they have not any common points. That's called as mutually exclusive. I hope that you cleared the point. What are the mutually exclusive? When they have no common points, they are not matching together. That's called as mutually exclusive events. Now I'm going to prove that how probability of A union B is equal to probability of A plus probability of B. So I'm going to prove that. So for that, next here, probability of A, first of all, I'm going to calculate probability of A. Probability of A is equal to number in A divided by number in sample space. So here, number in A is given here 1, 2, 3. 3 divided by total sample space. Here, total sample space is 6. So here, I put here 3 ones, that is equal 0.5. That's here. Next point. Now, I'm going to calculate probability of B is equal to number in B divided by number in sample space. Here, B is also 3 numbers. 3 over total sample space is 6. So put here will get also 0.5. That's clear. Now next step. Now next step is here A union B. Now I'm going to calculate here A union B. So here A is given here. A is given here 2, 4, 6. That's clear. Union. Next step is here B. 1, 3, 5. So here, next step is here, simply, now I'm going to calculate the union here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So here, A union B is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now I'm going to calculate that. Now I'm going to the next step. Probability of A union B, I'm going to calculate, will be equal to number in A union B divided by number in sample space. Simply, probability of A number in A and number in sample space. Probability of B number being the undesirable number surplus way. Similarly, probability of A union B is equal to number in A union B over number in surplus way. That's weird. So here, number in A union B are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 6. So here, I'm going to put the 6 numbers. And next, total surplus way. Total surplus way is 6. So here, 6 by 6, we will get here 1. So here now, I'm going to prove that probability of A union B. How to prove that? Very simply. So here, probability of A union B is equal to probability of A plus probability of B. So here, probability of A union B is equal to 1. That's near. Probability of A is equal to 0.5 plus probability of B is equal to 0.5. So this is 1, and 0.5 plus 0.5 will be 1. So I proved that also probability of A union B is always equal to probability of A plus probability of B. Thanks for watching this video. I hope that you have cleared the concept about the probability. As you can see, that probability is very, very easy. And also share this lecture with your classmates and friends so that they also have a benefit of it. And don't forget to like and subscribe this video. Goodbye.